I will come. You'll be blessed. I will be blessed. Everyone will be blessed in Jesus' name. There are 3 points I'm looking at in this message. Number one, glorious experiences of past retreats. Glorious experiences of past retreats. Number two, great expectations in the present retreat. Great expectation in the present retreat. And then number three, gathering for an exceptionally profitable retreat. Gathering for an exceptionally profitable retreat. Number one is a glorious experience of past retreats. The Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord, recognized the importance of special moments of withdrawal from the public, from public activities, to have concentrated, undisturbed fellowship with God the Father. He knew that that was a source of spiritual strength and extraordinary revelations. Therefore, he constantly withdrew his own disciples away from the activities of the busy life to do what? Number one, to instruct them. Number two, to inspire them. Number three, to impart grace and power unto them. That's why he called them. In fact, he has spoken about the glories of the coming kingdom. And then in Matthew chapter 17, 6 days after, he spoke about that glorious appearance of his coming kingdom. Then 6 days after, he took them so that they will be able to see the foretaste of the measure of the goodness of God in that coming kingdom. As you look at Matthew chapter 17, why don't you back up to Matthew chapter 16, the last verse there, verse 28. Verily I say unto you, there be some standing here which shall not taste of death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Maybe you didn't understand. Maybe they couldn't fathom. Maybe they couldn't explain. Maybe they couldn't measure what they were going to see. But 6 days after promising them that they were going to see the preview of his coming kingdom, then the Lord Jesus Christ took three of them to the Mount of Transfiguration. You need to remember that they had been praying every day as he taught them to pray, thy kingdom come, thy kingdom come. Yes, there is an eschatological fulfillment of that prayer, that is the coming kingdom of the latter time. But then there is also a present fulfillment of that prayer, thy kingdom come, the power of the kingdom, the glory of the kingdom, and the majesty of the kingdom, the beauty of the kingdom, and the spiritual impact of the kingdom. Let it come. Now at this time, they were to have a foretaste of the resplendent glory and excellent majesty of that kingdom. It was an uncommon retreat for them. And I think when the other people heard this or are not there, they must have been wishing, if we had been there too. Look at it in verse 1 now of Matthew chapter 17. After 6 days, Jesus taketh Peter, James, and John, his brother, and bringeth them up into an high mountain apart. The word apart, underline it in your Bible. Apart. And there are some things the Lord will do for us only when we come apart. When we come apart, he invites us. He says, there's something I want to do for you. But as you are in your normal business, in your market, in your office, in the multitude, in the society, I cannot do everything I want to do. I cannot say everything I want to say. I cannot bestow upon you everything I want to bestow upon you. Therefore, come apart. Follow me. And then they followed the Lord. And they went to this high mountain apart. I was transfigured before them. And his face did shine as the sun, and his raiment was white as light. And behold, there appeared unto them Moses and Elias talking with him. The question is, did they ever expect this? Well, Peter have ever expected he will see Moses. he'll see Elijah. Because you remember that Moses had gone ever long years before Peter was born, before James was born, and before John was born. They had read about Moses, but they had never seen him. You will see what you have read about, which you have never seen. You will hear what you have heard about, which you have never experienced, because a new experience is coming your way in Jesus' name. And then answered Peter and said unto Jesus, Lord, it is good for us to be here. I didn't do it to be like this. It is good for us to be here. And when you share that experience with us during this coming December retreat, you yourself will say, you give your testimony, you say, it is good for us to be here. Not only me, Peter, not only John, not only James, everyone. It is good for us to be here. In fact, to end that retreat, we have to just say now, we are closing, you must go back, because it is going to be a lot that the Lord will pour upon your life, that you will even want to say, if thou wilt, let us make here 3 tabernacles, one for thee and one for Moses and one for Elijah. Well, that's a wonderful experience that the people got, and you know, Peter never forgot that, because many years after that, when he was writing the second epistle of Peter, he said, we were there with him on the mountaintop. Let me tell you, he has seen many blind eyes open. He had even walked on the water. He has seen multitudes fed. He has seen many, many miracles. But this one was an unforgettable encounter for him. He never forgot that when he was writing many, many years after, he still mentioned it. What is going to happen to you during this coming retreat? Many, many years of Jesus studies, you will still be remembering. You remember that I've been attending retreat, but this special one that I attended, I will never forget. I was blessed before. I was going to the other retreats, and the Lord did wonderful, marvelous things in my life, but this particular one, I never thought it will be like this. It will be wonderful. In fact, if you remember when Moses, we've just read about Moses, when Moses appeared before the Lord, it was a retreat just for himself, because the children of Israel, they were not in the position, in the place where they will be with Moses at the mount of the Lord. In the case of Moses, when he went before the Lord, see what happened to him. In Exodus chapter 34, Exodus chapter 34, reading there from verse 29, and it came to pass when Moses came down from Mount Sinai, with the 2 tables of testimony in Moses' hand, when he came down from the mount, that Moses wist not, he knew not, that the skin of his face shone while he talked with him. That is, he was in the presence of God, just having fellowship with God. And there was no disturbance at all. There was no duty, there was no responsibility, there was no activity. Just staying in the presence of the Lord. And then he did not know that the presence of the Lord was doing something for him. And if his face changed like this, what change do you think took place in his heart? In his emotion, in his attitude, in his will, in his family. If the face, what they saw, what they couldn't see into his heart, they couldn't see into his soul, they couldn't see into his mind, they couldn't see into the inner man of Moses, but they saw the face of what they could see. They saw a great change. And even Moses did not know the extent of the change that had taken place in him. As you come to this retreat, you will not know the extent of the change of what will happen to you. It is when you get back home and the people are telling you, look at what you see. You're not like this, you're not like that, you're not like you used to be anymore. Because it will not just be a change on your face, it will be a change in your body. It will be a change in your heart. It will be a change in your family. It will be a change in your business. It will be a change in everything surrounding you, everything within you, in Jesus' name. And then we're told in verse 30, and when Aaron and all the children of Israel saw Moses, behold, the skin of his face shone, and they were afraid to come near him. If the people that were even close to him, think about Aaron and think about all these other children of Israel, if they were afraid to come near him because of the glory of God and the power of the Lord in his life, what do you think about enemies coming near? No, not at this time now. After this retreat, enemies will not be able to come near you. Those who want to do evil will not be able to come near you. There will be a fire. There will be a wall of fire around you. Because during this retreat, the Lord is going to come mightily upon your life. That even the people that were, you know, coming near before and they felt they could touch you, they could hurt you, they could do anything, they will not be able to come near to do anything evil against your life in Jesus' name. And then we're told in verse 33, till Moses had done speaking with them, he put a veil on his face. And then we're told when Moses went in before the Lord to speak to him, he took the veil off until he came out. And then we're told that he came out and spake unto the children of Israel that it was commanded in verse 35. And the children of Israel, they saw the face of Moses, that the skin of Moses' face shone. And Moses put the veil upon his face again until he went in to speak with him. Well, and that's the change that took place in him. And the Lord is calling us together so that as he calls us together, he will pour his glory upon every one of our lives once again in Jesus' name. I want to remind you that at the time of the Lord Jesus Christ, retreats like this wasn't anything surprising. In fact, it happened so many times and so often. A few of those instances are recorded for us. As you look at Mark chapter 8, you will see what happened to the people of Jesus' days, of Jesus' time. I want you to remember this, that Jesus went about doing good, healing all that were sick, all that were oppressed of the devil. And Jesus was teaching every time. Everywhere he went, he was teaching. And he will go into the synagogue, he will go into the side of the road, and then he will teach them. But apart from the day-to-day teaching, apart from the teaching in the synagogue, the teaching in the temple, there were special times when the people of God and the people that said, I've been receiving it, I've been getting it, I've been hearing it, I've been partaking of it, but we need a concentrated time all together from morning till evening, from day to day, for a number of days. We need to be with this Jesus Christ. And Jesus said in it to you that he needed a concentrated period of time when he will stay with them. And as he stayed with them, they were just taking the blessings of heaven and the dew of heaven and the rain of heaven and the showers from on high. There were times like that. That's why we keep to that as well. When the Lord himself, at the end of the year like this December, when he will cleanse everything that shouldn't go with us to the new year, and then he'll bring upon us refreshing and new blessing that will go with us into the new year. In Mark chapter 8, reading from verse 1. In those days, the multitude being very great and having nothing to eat, Jesus called his disciples unto him and says unto them, have compassion on the multitude, because they have now been with me, how many days? Tell me out loud. 3 days and have nothing to eat. The Lord said that here we have this great multitude. If you look at it in verse 1, in those days, the multitude being very great. The multitude is going to be very great during this December retreat. In every location where we're having the retreat, it's going to be very, very great. And everyone is going to be satisfied. Everyone is going to be satisfied. Because Jesus will be there. Almighty God will be there. The Spirit of God will be there. And miracles and the power of God will be flowing like you never saw it before. And Jesus said, I have compassion on the multitude. If the sick people are there, the Lord is going to have compassion on them. If people having yokes and bondages are there, the Lord is going to have compassion on them. And if the people that don't have any jobs, if they are there, the Lord is going to have compassion on them. I have compassion on the multitude because they they have been with me 3 days and have nothing to eat. I need to tell you something. There are people during the time of the retreat. But you know, some people, instead of spending 3 full days and knowing that I was there, 3 full days for the Lord. Some of them, they'll come maybe in the night and then rush away in the morning, and then maybe the following day they come back in the evening again. They'll spend 3 full days. I challenge you, and I want you to put the Lord to a test and prove me now, says the Lord, at this time you've been coming and going, and you have not been there. You have not been giving your full attention and the full time. Everything that it is to the 3 days, 3 full days of retreat. Do it this time and see what the Lord will do for you. The Lord will surprise you. The Lord will surprise your children. The Lord will surprise your parents as you are there. Because while you are there, let me tell you the secret. You come to the retreat, and then you stay indoors. You stay just in the presence of the Lord. Full days without going back home. And then the Lord is raining it upon you. And raining upon you. And raining upon you. Every prayer, you are there. Every song, you are there. Every benediction, you are there. Every testimony, you are there. Every period, you are there. Every message, you are there. How can you miss the blessing of God? No way. You will not miss the blessing of God. And so it says here in verse 3, and if I send them away fasting to their own houses, they will faint by the way. For divers of them came from far. Divers of them came from far. No matter how far you come, from the various areas you are living, to come to that central place, to come to that retreat location, the Lord will know. He will know how far you have come. He will know the journey you have taken. He will know the sacrifice that you have made, and is going to reward every little and every big sacrifice you make to come to that retreat location. And then he said, and his disciples answered him, from whence can a man satisfy these men with bread here in the wilderness? How are we going to satisfy these people? You know, these people did not even worry that there wasn't any place they were going to go to buy anything. In fact, they were not even interested in going out to buy anything from anywhere. They were just looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. They were just having the Lord Almighty in their presence all the time.